Hello? Who is this?
This is John Peterson. I'm with the CDC.
How did you get this number? Only Lord Jesus himself, Mrs. Claus, and Dead Moroz have this number.
Listen, Santa, I have good news and bad news. The good news is that the CDC has deemed your Santa's workshop to be an essential business. Kids need toys for Christmas, and you provide them.
Yes, of course, nothing is more essential than Christmas. But what's the bad news?
I'm afraid the way you run your business falls far short of what we would call acceptable, and we need you to make some changes before Christmas Eve. We've been trying to stop the spread of COVID-19, and it's getting tough during the holiday season. We've already prohibited public gatherings for Christmas, but we realize that you, Santa, are a super spreader.
The only thing I spread is joy. What's next? You will cancel Christmas? Listen, Mr. Peterson, I deliver gifts to kids and they wait for them a whole year.
Yes, we know. But to deliver those gifts, you must go house to house and climb down people's chimneys. Frankly, parents the world over are worried that your toys will be infected with the virus. And the last person they want in their house is a stranger who's literally been to every other house on the planet.
Listen, CDC, your agency has been around for what, 70 years? I've been doing this for thousands of years. I know what I'm doing. I haven't gotten sick now in at least a few centuries.
And how would you explain the reported cases of elves in your workshop testing positive for COVID-19?
We live in the North Pole. What do you expect? So they caught the cold. It's truly no big deal.
With all due respect, your workshop is a breeding ground for the virus. The elves work in close quarters, they do not get sick days, and they do not even wear masks.
My workshop is fueled by Christmas spirit. It heals everyone. Besides, your virus could have never arrived in the North Pole. We don't exactly get many visitors. Well, not since Will Ferrell.
Look, Mr. Claus, we're trying to be reasonable while keeping the situation under control. All we ask is that you make a few minor changes and follow our health and safety guidelines this Christmas Eve.
Okay, I am listening, but I'm kind of busy this time of year, so please keep it short.
There should be an option for your elves to work from home. Many tasks can be done over Zoom, and we believe this to be the safest option in your situation.
You clearly have never prepared gifts for 500 million children. We have to work inside the workshop. Zoom is no good for us.
In that case, you and your elves must wear masks. Plus, you have to make sure the elves are 6 feet apart while working. Your workshop must also have hand washing and temperature checking stations set up.
But we will be seriously behind on the toys if we have to start doing all of this.
And another thing, we understand that children send you letters every Christmas, but this is too dangerous. As we're trying to limit the spread of COVID-19, we plan on setting up an Instagram account for you so kids can send you online messages.
I may have to put you on the naughty list for even suggesting this. I enjoy watching a funny video as much as the next celestial being, but to suggest that I, Santa, would join Instagram is preposterous. Besides, if we don't get the great signal here in the North Pole, I have called Verizon and AT&T, but they hang up on me the moment they learn my address.
We also can no longer have you climb down people's chimneys to deliver gifts. The CDC commissioner is very strict on this one.
But I have to climb down the chimneys. It's the tradition. Kids leave me cookies and milk, and I can put coal in their stockings if they have been naughty.
It's not the 14th century, Santa. Just package the gifts and have them shipped to the kids. Haven't you heard of UPS? Much safer that way. And you shouldn't be eating their cookies and milk. It's an easy way to catch and spread the virus. How about kids leave you hand sanitizer instead?
Well, I just don't know. You can't change all the Christmas traditions. Next, I won't be riding on a magical sleigh with reindeer.
Oh no, that's about the safest form of travel right now. But if you insist on delivering them yourself, bear in mind that the toys must be quarantined for 3 days before kids can open them. They won't be able to see what they got until December 28th. Safety first.
But the kids have to open the presents on Christmas morning. That's how Christmas works.
Sorry, Santa. We can't let you be the only business that doesn't follow our safety procedures. And don't feel bad. It's not just you. We just reached an understanding with the Easter Bunny, who's on board to have eggs be delivered and sanitized. One last thing. We need to set up path tracing for you and your employees. To limit the spread of the virus, we need to know who you make contact with over Christmas.
But I go to every house!
In which case, you must avoid going to high-risk areas.
But I can't skip houses. Remember how before you were John Peterson with CDC, you were just Johnny? And at the age of 10, I brought you that shiny bike that you wanted so badly, and how happy it made you? Know this, Johnny. Christmas spirit is the best protection against this virus against all viruses. But I will admit, delivery via UPS does sound intriguing. Less wear and tear on the old sleigh. Just joking. Do not worry, kids. I'll be climbing down your chimney this Christmas just like any other. So please do not forget cookies and milk. Ho, ho, ho!
Thank you so much for watching this. We hope you enjoyed our little skit. And just remember what Christmas is all about. Christmas spirit, the joyfulness.
Merry Christmas, everybody. I hope Santa is good to you this year. I hope you're on the good list and you'll get lots of toys and presents. Ho, ho, ho!
Merry Christmas!